to the Raise Your Energy podcast. In today's episode, I want to talk to you about our habits of worrying. In my opinion, worrying has become a normal state of being these days. But in reality, it is big time overused, quite often useless, and actually makes us sick. So stay tuned to learn more. Somebody that worries a lot? Do you feel anxious about something or someone? Maybe you are not even that aware of being worried or anxious. These days it has become the norm to be worried about something at all times. People might even think that something is not quite right with you if you are in a conversation and say, "I have literally no worries." And you know what the other person might say? "Great that you have no worries, but what about the world out there? Are you not worried about humanity? Are you not worried about COVID? Are you not worried about ... It could be anything this person might throw at you. That's how normal it has become in our society that we have to worry at all times. And if it is not directly something in our life, well then, we better find something out there that we can worry about. But do we ever stop and reflect on what we are doing? What we are doing to ourselves and our health? What worrying and anxiety does to our lives? Well, we are going to do that today. I want you to wake up and reflect on this. I want you to understand what it does to you. I have always been good at worrying. Worrying is something that your mind does when it thinks about the future. Because it cannot predict the future, it starts worrying about it. It creates all of these scenarios of what might happen, and because our mind is more likely to think negatively, it goes automatically to worst case scenario. And it's difficult to get yourself out of it, right? I myself worried a lot at work. I had worries that were constantly on my mind. For example, worrying about all the tasks that I have not done yet and that still need to get done. Worrying if my boss will like the presentation that I have been working on for the last 3 days. Or how it will go when I have to give the presentation next week. Let's be honest, there is always something to worry about. Do you have such experiences? When I started to work more on my energy system and my thoughts, I started to see as well what worrying actually did to me. It would bring up feelings of not being good enough, unworthiness, scared to not getting the approval of others, or guilt for not doing a good enough job. These worrying thoughts combined with the feelings put a lot of stress on our bodies. Today, we are much more aware that this constant stress on our body is unhealthy and dangerous. Stress is the number one reason for most of our top illnesses. With the busyness of our lives and how much we deliver these days in our jobs, it is hard to eliminate all stress from our lives. But the stress we are creating with our worrying and anxious thoughts is something that we can eliminate or minimum start to reduce. The thing is that these thoughts and feelings are created artificially by our mind, and a lot of it is not helpful at all. Let me give you an example. Let's just say you are invited to go to a party on Saturday, and you have been looking forward to it for some weeks. And you just received a text message from a friend telling you that your former best friend is going to be there as well. There is a reason why, of course, this is your former best friend. I'm not going to go too much into that one now. So what does your mind go straight away to? It starts to create all of these scenarios of what could happen, right? You might be having thoughts like, how will it be meeting her after such a long time? What should I say to her? How should I behave when I meet her? What if she ignores me and pretends like we don't know each other, but everyone there knows about what happened 2 years ago? What if she does not ignore me and she comes over and is super nice to me, as if nothing ever happened? Should I play along and do the same? Or should I call her out on the fight we had a few years ago? All of these thoughts are happening straight away. And they will probably happen all the way to Saturday. Who knows what kind of crazy scenarios the mind comes up with until the party, right? And every time you think about it, you create feelings alongside of these thoughts. Feelings like nervousness, being scared, frustration, shame, or anger. What is currently happening is, it is Tuesday afternoon. You are standing in your kitchen and you are going through these thoughts and feelings. You are putting your body under a lot of stress. You are signaling your system to create stress hormones. Your system thinks that you are currently in the situation that you are picturing, as if it is currently happening. Your body does not know the difference between it being real or just imagined in your mind. Your body is under full stress, releases chemicals that it does not really need, because in reality it is standing safe and sound in your kitchen. And how many more times are you going to do that to your body until Saturday? Let's be honest. You might not be able to leave it at this one time on Tuesday afternoon, right? You might have similar thoughts again on Wednesday morning at breakfast, on Thursday afternoon while driving in your car, and for sure, Friday evening, the evening before the party. Each time, you're creating a stress scenario in your body and making yourself unwell. And for what? You cannot know what will happen. Our mind is not able to look into the future. And have you had these kind of situations before where you created these worst case scenarios in your mind and what happened in the end? It was all not that bad. Sometimes not even anything bad happened. You might be looking back and thinking, oh, I had nothing to worry about. Everything went actually better than I thought. Is that not what happens most of the time? But what did we do to ourselves leading up to that event? We created a lot of stress in our system. We spent a lot of energy having these thoughts and these feelings. And how much time have we spent worrying? And then we say to ourselves, I don't have enough time. Yeah, right. And even if, in the unlikely scenario that the situation ended up being one of the scenarios you imagined, and it might have been awkward for 5, maximum 10 minutes. Does that really warrant all the worries throughout the week? Is it really worth it to say, see, I was right, I knew this would happen? Or is it better to start worrying less about things that we cannot predict? Is it not better to put less stress on our body and our system and to be healthier? In the end, it is of course your choice. You are creating these thoughts and these feelings. And if you understand this now, you can start changing them. You have the control to choose differently. It is hard and needs a lot of practice to not have worrying thoughts at all, especially in scenarios like this. They will just come, let's face it. That does not mean that you need to keep having them for the next 10 or even 30 minutes. You can choose differently. You can choose to stop the cycle of worries and the feelings that come with it. Here are a couple of things you could do. Say to yourself, stop the worries. This does not help me or my body. Let's think about something different. Or you could distract yourself. Take a few deep breaths and do something different that will distract your mind and occupy your mind in a different way. Or you could write it all down. Getting your thoughts out of your mind and onto paper is very healing and releasing. Once they are out, you will feel lighter and more objective. Seeing the thoughts written down on paper might help you see the craziness in some of these. And the last tip I have for you is to move your body and your mind to a happier place. This can be a safe haven for you to go to when you need it, especially in situations like this. It could be a nice memory, a location where you like to spend your time, a mantra, or you could literally create a place in your mind that you go to switch off these worrying thoughts and to create positive feelings in your body straight away. I created a meditation just for this, as I wanted to create such a place for myself when I need it. This meditation is designed for you to let go of worries and anxious thoughts. By handing them over to a higher power, you create space in your life for peace and love. The place you're going to create in that meditation keeps you calm and safe. Are you ready to build your space of inner peace? Well then, let this meditation guide you through this journey. I will add the link to the meditation in the show notes. And I will close our episode today with this great quote from Irma Bombeck. Worry is like a rocking chair. It gives you something to do, but it never gets you anywhere. And with that, I love you and leave you. Talk soon and bye-bye.